sa ating mga kasama sa media today. The Quadcom will turn over documents pertaining to the land acquisitions and properties believed to be owned, procured, acquired by Chinese nationals. In the course of the investigation of the Committee on Public Accounts and the Committee on Dangerous Drugs, we have discovered that there are several Chinese personalities who acquired thousands of hectares of land in the province of Pampanga. And this was the result. These documents are the findings of the Committee on Public Accounts and the Committee on Dangerous Drugs, where corporations owned, majority owned by Chinese, ang na-discover natin that acquired these properties. And now we will, the part of the recommendation of the committee, the Quad Committee, is to turn over these documents to the Office of the Solicitor General in order to conduct their own investigation for possible for future proceedings for these properties. Malaki ho ang na-discover dito sa laki ng lupang nabili ng mga Chinese nationals, no? Na alam naman po natin that the Constitution prohibits foreign nationals from acquiring 100% ownership ng ating mga lupa at ng mga pagtatayo ng mga korporasyon. So, today, as a, just to let the people know na ito ay trabaho ng Quadcom, at gusto naming i-emphasize na ang Quadcom ay walang politika, kundi trabaho lamang. And that's why we're privileged to have with us today our representatives from the Office of the Solicitor General, Attorney Hermes Ocampo, the Assistant Solicitor General, Attorney Gilbert Medrano, the Assistant Solicitor General, Attorney Neil Lorenzo, the Senior State Prosecutor. So, welcome and thank you for joining us here in this turnover of petition for civil forfeiture sa Office of the Solicitor General. So, can we turn this over now? So we will now open the floor for questions from our friends in the media. But before that, please allow me to acknowledge the presence of Congressman Rog Gutierrez, Congressman Paolo Ortega, my co-chair in the Quadcom, Congressman Dan Fernandez, and of course my co-chair, the chair of the Committee on Public Accounts, Congressman Caraps Paduano. So we will now entertain questions. You can ask questions. Yes, Tina.
Good morning po, sirs. Sir, can you mention prominent Chinese personalities na involved po dito sa mga documents na na-turn over po ninyo?
Okay, we will ask the chairman of the Committee on Public Accounts the names of the owners of these properties.
Good morning, everyone. Anyway, during the last year's hearing, lumabas na po yung pangalan ni a certain Eddie Tayang, in which the Bureau of Immigration confirms that Eddie Tayang is a Chinese citizen, with being a passport holder of a Chinese, no, in the person of Judge Jing Yang. And he was also involved in the sale of properties for Mexico, the LGU of Mexico Pampanga, and also involved in the corporation, the Empire 999, the Sunflare, and ayun, Mexico pa, Mexico 999 and Empire 999 and Sunflare, Eddie Tayang involved in those corporations, in which well, in fact, he was cited in contempt. I think, if my memory serves me right, that was November of last year pa, and until now he is at large, and having transaction with the LGU of Mexico Pampanga, particularly during the time of Mayor Tumang.
In addition also to the names mentioned by Congressman Paduano, a certain Willie Ong also have acquired hundreds, based on our records, we have 300 land titles registered under his name. And Mr. Willie Ong has likewise been identified as a Chinese national. So he organized a corporation called Empire 999, and there are also acquisitions under his name. So, yan. And then Tony Yang, the brother of Michael Yang.
Sir, can you give us an estimate kung gaano ka laki yung halaga ng mga properties na nabili ng Chinese nationals?
We as of now, we cannot yet, of course, the actual yung worth ng properties, no? But thousands of hectares po ang involved dito. And what is prominent is the corporations, no? That was owned by these Chinese nationals, yung Empire 999 po, as I've said, Sunflare, at saka Empire 999 and Sunflare po.
In addition to that, ano, para at least medyo klaro, kasi yung Empire 999, Realty Corporation, isang company lang yun. Consider mo yung pinag-uusapan ditong titles, almost 300 titles, isang corporation. So meaning, marami pa tayong hindi na-discover ng mga corporations that are Chinese pretending to be Filipinos. So yun ang malaking trabaho na dapat nating asikasuhan, especially ang ating pong Solicitor General, na makita itong mga corporation na to, na marami mga pure Chinese na pretending to be Filipinos and owning and buying properties.
Sir, sir, just a clarification, Chinese lang po ba, walang mga Filipino officials na naging kasabwat nila para mabili yung mga property na yan dyan sa sinabit ninyong documents sa Solgen?
Hindi, katulad
nyo. Ay, ikaw na, brother. Sige. As I've said, particularly with the transaction between Eddie Tayang and the sale of property which is worth 79.5 million in Mexico, Pampanga, the person of interest involved here is the former mayor, Eddie Tayang, Mayor Tumang, Dede Tumang. Alam po naman natin na he was already dismissed twice by the Office of the Ombudsman. So, kung Filipino po, lahat na mga properties that was sold to Mexico Pampanga kay Teddy, kay Mayor Teddy Tumang po, at saka yung mga some of the employees, particularly Roy Gomez, no, is involved and until now also at large. And doon po sa sale ng property with regards to the warehouse that where the Cebu was discovered doon po sa Mexico, ang involved din po dito yung kapatid ni Mayor Tumang at the same time si Mayor Tumang po on the sale of that property with regards to that warehouse. So those are the Filipinos which is inclusion with these Chinese nationals.
I think let me emphasize also, no, na ito sila ay nagpanggap ng mga Pilipino. gumamit sila ng mga peke at mga spurious na mga dokumento na magpapatunay na sila ay mga Pilipino. Until after we have discovered na sila po ay mga Chinese nationals. Meron din po sila mga ginamit na mga dummies, no? Na mga Filipino, apparently Filipino-Chinese. No, nandyan ho yan sa ating mga listahan. So makikita po natin na ito ay panlilin lang, no, sa atin, no, dahil talagang gumamit sila ng mga dokumentong pagpapanggap na sila ay mga Pilipino.
Sir, saka yung issue to that, no, kailangan din critical tayo doon sa PSA saka doon sa local civil registrar. Very particular tayo doon dahil doon tayo doon na lang yun ang ginamit ng mga Chinese. Ang PSA, nag-relax sila doon sa requirements sila para sa birth certificate. Also doon sa mga local civil register. Kaya yun nga, sana itong ating pong solicitor general have to look deeper doon sa problem ng PSA sa local civil register.
Sir?
Of course, we'd like to acknowledge also the presence of our overall vice chair, Congressman Romiaco. Good morning. Yes, Mela.
Sir, tanong ko lang po, from the side of Office of the Solicitor General, ano pong masasabi niyo dito sa mga itinurn over na dokumento ng Quadcom at moving forward, ano po ba yung magiging proseso niyo rito?
Hindi pa po namin nakikita yung contents ng mga documents turned over to us now, pero may mga listahan po dito sa invitation ng mga honorable chairpersons ng Quadcom, aaralin po namin to. Pero initially po, ito po kasi yung mga possible na actions that may be filed by the OSG with the coordination of the pertinent government agencies, for example, sa civil forfeiture of the assets acquired of this Chinese through AMLA yan, AMLA, and ito rin for the reversion and or SG proceedings to recover yung mga fraudulently acquired real estate by this Chinese. Pero ito po, aaralan namin mabuti kung ano yung real status of this lands now. Whether or not in the meantime, these lands have been transferred to qualified Filipino individuals or entities, in which case jurisprudentially the defect, the constitutional defect, is deemed cured. So ang pan lang nito, if the real estate is still in the name of this Chinese, we will file the necessary actions, escheat or reversion. Then, kung ito po, pag nasa pangalan na to ng mga Filipino individuals, cured na po yan. Pero subject po sa possible administrative or criminal actions yung mga involved, including mga government officials, kung if there's any.
Sir?
You know.
Sir? May dalawang tanong lang po ako. No? Yung unang-una ay ilang mga Chinese po yung nasa listahan po natin na binigay po natin dyan sa OSG. Pangalawa, pwede po bang paki-describe kung itong pinabanggit po na mga lupain o property, pwede na po bang makabuo ng isang munisipyo o lungsod sa laki ng mga property na pinag-uusapan po natin? Salamat po.
Ang aming estimate, thousands of hectares eh. Ito nga nandito, we do not have the final figure, pero kung babasihan natin yung number ng titulo na acquire, no, na ilipat sa pangalan ng Chinese national o hindi kaya doon sa kanyang korporasyon na nirehistro, lumalabas ito, umaabot ito sa mga 300 hanggang 400 na titulo. So if you estimate that each title would have at least a hectare of land, so doon lang sa isang tao, sa isang korporasyon, meron na silang estimated 400-500 hektaryang lupa sa isang kumpanya lamang yon. So tama yung sinabi ni Attorney Ocampo, that they will study this, initiate the SCHIT proceedings. Kasi if ever we recover this, it has to be recovered in favor of the national government. Kasi nga, merong fraud na nangyari. Bumili sila ng lupa. All these properties are fraudulently acquired. I don't know kung ano yung purpose. Yung iba, ang ginawa nila, nagtayo sila ng mga warehouses, nagtayo sila ng ibang negosyo, and possibly, no, kung nakalusot ito, baka nagkaroon na naman ng Pogo hub dyan sa mga lugar na yan.
And siguro in addition, no, Mr. Chairman, kasi we have to be expedite yung lahat ng issues pertaining to the properties that were owned by the Chinese people pretending to be Filipinos. Si Secretary Lucas Bersamin issued a preservation asset na kung saan doon sa asset preservation doon sa Banban na kung saan nakapreserve yung asset po nila para hindi na mabenta. Now, sana yun nire-request natin sa Solicitor General to coordinate with the Executive Secretary in order to have a to issue agad yung ating asset of preservation while they are doing yung mga documentary documents that need to be done para makapag-issue sila ng mga preservation of those all assets, no. Maganda yung ginawa po ni Secretary Lucas Bersamin. Sana magawa din po ng ating Solicitor General.
Chairman?
Yes, ma'am.
Anyway, dun po sa number of Chinese personalities involved, ang most prominent, of course, is Eddie Tayang and Willie Ong. But in those corporations mentioned, particularly Sunflare, which is based in San Simon, Pampanga, and Empire 999, which is based in Mexico, Pampanga, if not all, most of those incorporators are Chinese. Now, in the case of properties, sabi nga ni OSG kanina, na-cured. There are one case, no? Isang case po, property of Eddie Tayang, in which it was claimed to be his residence in Mexico, Pampanga, and it was bought by a certain Rodingo. But when he was invited during the hearing, in good faith, he bought that property, and he's very much willing to cooperate po dun sa process, legal process with regards to those properties, no? Isang property lang naman po yun. And I hope we hope that some of those properties are still nakabitin po. No? That's why we have to move fast so that all those properties will be reverted back to the government. Thank you po.
Okay, we'd like to acknowledge also the presence of our Deputy Speaker, J.J. Suarez. Good morning, DS J.J. So,
Sir, clarification ulit. Yung mood ng pagbili ng mga properties na yan, paano ang natuklasan ba ng Quadcom through money laundering, cash ba yan o binayaran, yung pera ba ay galing sa proceeds ng drugs, paano? At saka Pogo pala.
Patuloy pa rin yung ating investigation dyan. No? As far as the paano sila nakapag-acquire, of course, they possess fraudulent documents pertaining saying that they are all Filipinos. Kaya, regular, no? Merong presumption of regularity doon sa kanilang pag-acquire nito mga properties na to. Now, nasa proseso po ngayon ng Quadcom ang pag-determine whether ito bang mga ginamit na pera pambili ay isang paraan para makapag-launder o makapaghuga sila o makapaglaba, no, in layman's language, ng kanilang pera. No, that hopefully we will be able also to discover kung ano yung source ng pondong ito. Okay.
Kung tanong ko lang, sakaling magsusulong tayo ng panukalang batas, ano po ba ang nais nating isulong ng Quadcom, especially dito sa pag-acquire ng napakaraming mga land titles ng mga foreigners? And then, ano po ba yung pananagutan ng PSA, lapses, dahil nga nabibigyan kaagad ng mga birth certificate po itong mga Banyaga? Thank you.
Well, dun sa pag-acquire nila ng property bilang foreigner, eh, nasa constitution po yan. So hindi na po siguro kailangan gumawa ng batas because there was a clear violation of the provision of the Constitution. Pero doon sa PSA, yan po ang aming pinag-aaralan sa ngayon. No? Kailangan maging mahigpit yung requirements para bago sila mag-issue ng Certificate of Live Birth. Lalo-lalo na doon sa mga nag-a-apply under the policy of late registration. Kasi karamihan dito sa mga Chinese nito ay late registration. So, doon pa lang, dapat magtaka nga tayo eh. 18, Alice Go, for example, 19 years old na siya nung nag-apply siya for Filipino citizenship. Sabi niya, late registration dahil daw lumaki siya sa farm, hindi na asikaso nung kanyang mga magulang, no? Yung pagka-re-registro sa kanya. Kaya nga, isa yan sa tinitingnan itong Quadcom. Kasama dyan, yung ating local civil registrar. Kasi ang endorsement nang gagaling sa kanila eh, bago yan umakyat doon sa PSA. So, tinitingnan din natin in these two agencies kung ano pwede natin gawin na mga batas, no? O panukalang batas para higpitan natin yung pag-implement nila ng mga pulisiyang ito.
To add, no? Actually, yung problema lagi dyan, yung defense ng PSA. First, binabalik nila doon sa LCR because they're just receiving the documents coming from the local civil registry. Now, second na defense lagi nila is ministerial daw yung role niya. That's why during the hearing of public in public accounts, nilaw po natin na dapat we have to do something about it. We have to legislate laws that will make sure na hindi na po lulusot itong mga kasong ganito. Not only Alice Go, in the case of Edie Tayang, alam mo, 1983 siya pinanganak, yung registration na dito sa Filipino citizen after 23 years o 21 years, 2004. So, doon po sila nakakalusot. Kaya kailangan we have to legislate laws na masiguro po natin na hindi ito lumusot in the future. Yung mga ganito pong kalakaran.
Saka in addition to that, ano, kasi yung PSA, meron silang service provider para dun sa kanilang automation doon sa ating pong tinatawag po nating registration, no? At ang service provider nila for so many years, no? I think 10 taon na yung service provider na yon. And they spend like, I think, if I'm not mistaken, during the investigation namin, wala pa sa Quadcom to. If I am right, kung hindi sa dangerous drug, sa public accounts, na-mention dun yung contract. Ang contract na inabot ng PSA, no, doon sa service provider nila, almost, I think, if I'm not mistaken, 5 billion. So, kung meron tayong ganong klase ng kontrata, no, doon sa PSA, being owned by a private corporation, not owned by the government, at stake yung ating, ano, tinatawag ng mga profile ng bawat Pilipino na dumadaan sa kanila. And I think the Solicitor General have to check on this as well. Yung contract ng PSA doon sa UNICEF. UNICEF ang kontrata nila eh. At sa UNICEF, according to this federal investigation that was conducted in the United States, meron silang case against this UNICEF Corporation. We tackle this in the committee and I think it is imperative on the part of the Solicitor General to look into this.